Many evolutionists admit that life from non-living chemicals is a huge problem for life on Earth. So they've resorted to the idea that maybe life came from outside the Earth, and this is called panspermia. Now, there are two versions of this one. One is undirected, which just says that chemical evolution happened somewhere and life was naturally seeded onto Earth somehow. Now, this doesn't actually solve the problem of life from non-living chemicals. It just puts it into the unknown. In fact, it puts it beyond science. So you might say it's a Darwin of the gaps theory, not science at all. Another idea is called directed panspermia, where you have intelligent aliens seeding life from outer space onto Earth.
Francis Crick, the primary discoverer of DNA, is one of those scientists who realized it can't happen spontaneously. So he, like other scientists, are imagining that intelligent life from outer space brought life to Earth, and they find that more credible than the idea of spontaneous origin of life.
Evolutionists who resort to directed panspermia are in fact tacitly conceding that life was intelligently designed. The only difference is their designer is an alien, not the God of the Bible. Of course, this is most convenient for them because a God of the Bible has certain moral requirements while aliens don't. So they can have all the benefits of a designer without the moral obligations to him.